Hello friends, I'm Katrinah, and in this video I'm going to show you how to create a beautiful e-commerce WordPress website using merchandiser theme by Get Bowtied. This is a premium professional WordPress theme, which means lots of extra features have been built in to help your website stand out. So let's take a quick tour around the website we'll be creating in this video using merchandiser theme. So here we are on the homepage of the website we'll be creating in this video using merchandiser theme by Get Bowtied. At the top, as expected, we have our menu navigation items, our website title, and on the right-hand side, we have some other items to make it really easy to navigate throughout the website. In this particular version of this theme, because this theme can be customized in so many different ways, but for this particular demo tutorial, I have created or used merchandiser theme to set up a slider right here. So we see that we have a background image, a title, subtitle, and a call to action. And when I click on any one of these arrows, it rotates to a beautiful slider with another image of one of the products within my online store. Because this is an e-commerce website, when I scroll down, I'm featuring the various product categories within my store here with these beautiful larger images. And when we scroll down even further, we can see I featured brand new products within my shop. And then I have this kind of call out featured section here once again with a title, subtitle, or I should say a short description and a call to action. Pretty cool. Then when I scroll down even further, I've highlighted other products that I want to feature on my homepage. And last but not least, I have a blog post. So this particular theme, as I mentioned, can be customized in so many different ways. I'll show you in this video how you can make whatever customizations you'd like to make. Now let's take a look at some of the internal pages of this site. When I go over to the shop page, here we can see an absolutely gorgeous archive page or shop page for our online store. We have on the left-hand side some customizable content in the sidebar. We can filter by price or by product categories. And of course, on the right-hand side, we have the products within my online store. Now, the cool thing is when I hover over one of these particular items, I can see that this image kind of gets a little bit larger so I can see it. And the really cool thing about this particular theme, merchandiser theme, is that there's this quick view button, which when I click on that, this section will pop up, this kind of off-canvas section, where I can see this one item without really leaving the whole shop page. So cool. Now, of course, if you'd like to check out more about this particular product, you can do so by clicking on View Details, and this will bring you to the actual product page. So here I have my item. I have the title, the price, a short description, and the Add to Cart button. And then scrolling down, we have a longer description about this product, and last but not least, some related products. The other thing I want to point out about this theme is that there's also this area right up here, which when you see this little shop icon or cart icon, I should say, when I click on that, the same exact thing happens. This off-canvas cart opens up where I've not yet left the product page, but I can still see really clearly what's in my cart. So cool. If you'd like to check out the cart, you can do so by clicking on View Cart. And here we have a gorgeous display of our cart with an icon, a thumbnail image of the product name, price, the quantity, and the total price. Then, of course, here we see our cart totals. To proceed to checkout, I'm going to click on that here so we can check out what the checkout page looks like. And once again, we can see this is just a really lovely design when it comes to a checkout page. So everything about this theme is very professional, very upscale, and it will really help your branding as well as establish credibility because the design is just so gorgeous with this theme. So here we are back on the homepage of our website using merchandiser theme, and this is the view that we're going to be creating in this video. The great thing about this theme, however, is that there's lots of customizations that you can create with this theme. So if you'd like to have a different homepage view, you can do that with this theme very easily without knowing any code. So let's take a look at one of the alternative homepage views that you can create with merchandiser theme. So when I pop on over to the Get Bowtied site, here we can see this looks very familiar. This is the version that I'm creating in this video that we're watching right now. However, an alternative homepage view is this one right here. When I hover over home and click on featured products, Here we can see you can create this version for a homepage instead if you would like. I'll show you some steps how to get started with this alternative view in this video. So you'll have many different variations and options to completely make your website uniquely your own. Now let's take a look at some of the internal pages within this website as well. Starting with the About page, to go to the About page, I'm going to hover over Home and then click on About. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to customize your About page so it looks very similar to this. Here we have an image background as well as a title, then we'll have a section with a quote, and we'll have a variety of additional sections. A number of other pages are built in with the Merchandiser theme when you install the demo content, and I'll be showing you in this video exactly how to install these pre-built pages as well as customize them. One of the best things about the Merchandiser theme is that it comes with built-in pages to help you save time in creating really unique and very stylish pages for your website. One of the pages that comes built in is this image gallery, and I'll be showing you step by step in this video how to set this page up. Here we see when I click on any one of these items, it opens up into a really gorgeous light box display, which makes viewing the items in the portfolio really easy. So I'll be showing you in this video how to set up a portfolio page with a lightbox display that looks just like this. This theme also comes with a blog, so I'll be showing you how to set up your blog within this video. And I want to make a note that similar to all the pages within Merchandiser theme, you can customize the layout of your blog once again to create a layout and a design that is uniquely your own. Last but not least, Merchandiser theme is completely responsive and mobile friendly, which means it will look amazing on all screen sizes, from desktops to tablets to smartphones and anything in between. As a quick demo of the responsiveness of this particular theme, when I come to the bottom right hand corner and reduce the screen size, we can see that everything starts to line up really well, and we can see now in this smaller screen size, this is the iPhone version or an Android version here, we see now the menu has collapsed on the left-hand side, so when I click on that, I now get this side open menu right here, which is really cool, and I can navigate throughout the website. And then here we have the menu, or I should say the logo and website title, and here is the cart icon up above. Now when I click on that, we see that even in the mobile view, this off-canvas cart opens up, which makes it really easy to view the cart while at the same time staying on whatever page you are currently looking at. Then of course we have the title, subtitle, and the call to action with a background image in the back. And then as I scroll down, all of the various items have stacked really nicely, one on top of the other, so that you have this beautiful mobile version view. So you're good to go on responsiveness and mobile readiness when you're using the Merchandiser theme by Get Bowtied. So this is where we're headed toward in this video. We're going to be creating a beautiful e-commerce WordPress website and online store using Merchandiser theme by Get Bowtied. This video tutorial is sponsored by Get Bowtied, so a big shout out of thanks to everyone on the team at Get Bowtied for your support in helping me to continue to create these free WordPress training videos on YouTube. So without further ado, let's dive in and get started. So to create this website, we need a few things. Number one, we need a domain name, and number two, we need web hosting. In this video, I'm going to be using hostgator.com for both the domain name as well as the web hosting. So here we are on hostgator.com. First up, we need to click on this yellow button in the middle that says Get Started Now. Once you click on Get Started Now, then you'll arrive on this page where you can choose the web hosting plan that you would like. So when I scroll down, for example, we see that there's three different plans to choose from: Hatchling plan, baby plan, and a business plan. If you're just getting started with your website, most likely you can use the Hatchling plan and that should be sufficient. So to keep within my budget for this demo purpose, I'm only going to be hosting one demo website using the Hatchling plan. So I'm going to click on sign up now for the Hatchling plan. Then I'll arrive on this page and I need to register my new domain name. So right in this box, I'm going to add my new domain name. And once you have the domain name available, then you want to just scroll down to the bottom. Here we see there's domain privacy protection as an option. I always get this because basically what this does is it prevents all of your information, like your email address, your phone number, your address, things like that. It prevents that and hides that from being included in an online database related to your website. So I always think it's a good idea to invest in this, but it's up to you. If you'd like to save some money, then of course you can uncheck it. So decide whatever works best for you, check it or uncheck it, and then we'll move forward. And here we have choose a hosting plan. So we've already chosen the Hatchling plan. I'm going to choose 6 months at a time because that is the best value with the coupon I'm going to share with you in just a moment. Then you add your username, your security PIN, enter your billing info. Then you want to scroll down and we have some more options. These are all optional, so read through these if you'd like. I'm not going to order these, however, so I'm going to uncheck them. And then down below, here we see that I have to enter a coupon code. So the coupon code by default is this one right here, but I have a special coupon code, which will give you more money off, more of a discount. So it's always good. Everyone always loves to save more money. So I'm going to add that one right here. It's WP coupon 25. We can see we're going from $58 for 6 months of web hosting to, voila, when I click on validate, it goes down to $49. So if you'd like to get an extra amount off of your order, feel free to use my coupon code WPCoupon25. Now, if you don't want to sign up for 6 months at a time, I have another coupon that will give you more of a value for, this is the best coupon for 1 month, for example. So when I come down here, click on billing cycle, 1 month only, so we're going month to month. Then I scroll down to the coupon code. The best coupon when you're signing up for 1 month at a time is 1 month bonus. So I'm going to pop in 1 month bonus coupon code there and click on validate. And now we can see that my total is under $13. Super cool. So choose the one that works best for you, either WP coupon 25 or 1 month bonus. And I do want to note that I do receive a small referral when you use either of my coupons. And thank you so much for your support in helping me to continue to create free WordPress training videos. Okay, so once you have all of that set, you want to review the details of your order, scroll to the bottom, click on this button here that says you have read the terms of service after you've read them, of course, and then click on this yellow button that says check out now. So once you click on create your account, you'll get this page, which will thank you for your order and will tell you to go check your email for information related to logging into your web hosting account. So I'm going to go check out my email. And here we see on my email account, here's the email from HostGator with my account info. So I'm going to click this email to open it. And I want to point out two things. Number one, the first link that they'll share with you in the email is the billing system link. And then right below that, you'll see that there's a link for your control panel with your username and a temporary password. So I'm going to copy this password here, the temporary password, and to log into your control panel, you'll use this link. So I'm going to click on this link here, and then here is my username. You want to type in your username, and then you want to add your password right here as well. Once you have that set up, you want to click on login to log into the customer portal of your HostGator account. So once you're logged in, you'll see these tabs at the top. You want to click on the one that says hosting, and once you're on the hosting tab, then to install WordPress, you want to scroll to the bottom here where it says launch quick install, and click on launch quick install. Once we click on quick install, then we want to go to the left-hand side, and here where it says WordPress, we want to click on WordPress. Once we click on WordPress, then we'll see this install WordPress for free section, and then we want to click on this button that says install WordPress. And then here we want to fill out the form to get started with our install. So you just want to choose which website you need right here. And once you filled out the form, then you can click on this button here to install WordPress. Once your WordPress installation is complete, you'll get a message at the top here that says your install is complete. Click here to view your notifications, and you can also view your credentials. So then I'm just going to click on this little caret here to view my credentials, and here we can see I can go directly to the admin area by clicking on this link here, and here's my username and my password. So you just want to copy your password, highlight and copy it, click on this link, and then you can log in to your new WordPress website. So once you log into your WordPress website, you'll arrive on the dashboard, and this is the first thing you'll see when you log into your WordPress website. When you first install WordPress, you'll also see this welcome message in the middle that says welcome to WordPress with a number of links to get started. I'm going to be going over these later on in the video, however, so I'm not going to cover these now. Instead, I'm going to dismiss this message altogether by clicking on this link here that says dismiss. Also note that if you are installing WordPress using the HostGator quick install, which I just showed a few moments ago, you'll also have this Ninja Forms message at the top, because when you install WordPress using quick install, it comes with Ninja Forms. So I'm going to be turning this off later in the video. For now, we don't need this message either, so I'm going to dismiss this as well by clicking on this X right here to dismiss this message. Now, the cool thing about the dashboard is you can arrange everything and customize it the way you'd like to see it. Here at the top, we have the at a glance. This is showing you how many posts, pages, and comments you have on your website. And when you first install WordPress, you'll have one post, one comment, and one page. These are defaults that come with your WordPress installation. Also note that we can see at the time of this recording, I am using WordPress version 4.4.2 and running the 2016 theme, which is the theme that comes with our WordPress installation. Then down below, we'll see some activity, comments, and things like that. On the right-hand side, we have quick drafts and some WordPress news. So if you'd like to move this stuff around, you can do so by simply dragging the boxes and moving them over, or dragging them back. And if you'd like to remove them all together, you can do so by simply coming up to the top where it says Screen Options, clicking on Screen Options, and then you can turn this off altogether by unchecking these boxes. We can see when I do so, all the boxes in the dashboard disappear. So the cool thing is you can easily put them back by simply clicking on them once again. I'll leave all of them up there with the exception of the welcome message. Okay, when you have your dashboard looking as you'd like it to look, go ahead and click on Screen Options to collapse those options. Okay, so now let's take a look at what our WordPress website looks like right out of the box when we first install WordPress. To check out what the site looks like, you want to go up to the top left-hand corner, hover over your website name, and click on Visit Site. Here we can see, using the 2016 theme without it being configured, this is what it looks like. So we have quite a bit of work to do, because where we're headed toward in this video, by the time we're finished this video, our website is going to look just like this. We'll have our menu navigation items followed by our logo or our website title, and on the right-hand side we'll have some icons to navigate around the website. Underneath that, we'll have our slider with a background image, a title, a subtitle, and a call to action. And then underneath that, we're going to have some product category images along with a link to those categories. Then we'll have some featured items within our brand new store. And then we'll have another featured section here with a background image, title, description, and call to action. Last but not least, we'll feature a few more items and wrap it all up with a blog post. So this is the style that we're going toward in this video. So we can see that this website looks so much different than the one that we currently are working on with the 2016 theme, which is right here. So in order to change our theme and move in the direction of our finished website, right here, first step, we need to change the theme from the built-in 2016 theme to our new merchandiser theme. So going back to our dashboard, we're going to click on Dashboard right here in the top left-hand corner. Then I'm going to go down to Appearance, hover over Appearance, and click on Themes. So here on the themes panel, we can see the three themes that came with our WordPress installation. We have the 2014 theme, 2015 theme, and here we have the 2016 theme, which is currently active. So we need to actually add a new theme. So to add this theme to our website, because Merchandiser theme is a premium theme, we need to go find it, buy it, and download it from Theme Forest. I'll be sure to drop a link down below so you can easily find it. Once I click on the link to go to Theme Forest, then on Theme Forest, we see the item product detail. As it notes at the top, Merchandiser e-commerce WordPress theme for WooCommerce. Awesome. So to buy this, I'm going to click on this button here that says Buy Now. And here on the checkout page, you can create an account if you don't yet have a ThemeForest account, or if you do already have an account, you can sign in by clicking on this button here. I already have an account, so I'm gonna sign in by clicking on this sign in button. Once you add your username and password, go ahead and click on this button to sign in to your ThemeForest account. Once you sign in to your ThemeForest account, you arrive on the checkout page where you can fill out your billing details, select your payment method, and pay for the merchandiser theme. Once you've selected the payment method you'd like to use, go ahead and click on the button at the bottom that says checkout. Once you make your payment on PayPal, then you'll arrive on this page, which is the payment complete page for ThemeForest. And as we can see, here's a download button to download the files of our new theme. So to download the files, I'm gonna click on this button here that says download. So once a file has been downloaded to our computer, next up we need to unzip this package. So here on my desktop, here is the merchandiser.zip file. So I wanna open this by double clicking on it. Then you'll have this box pop up and I'm gonna click on extract to extract the files. And then you'll have a new folder on your desktop that says merchandiser. And when I click on this folder, we'll see there's a number of different files within it, including a license folder, licensing, as well as the theme files. Now, when I double click on theme files, we'll see there's two themes here. We have the parent theme, which is merchandiser.zip, and we have the child theme, merchandiser-child. So we want to install both of these files. So for now, I'm going to close this. Then I'm going to go back to my WordPress website. Here I am on the dashboard, and I'm going to scroll down to Appearance and click on Themes. Here we can see the existing theme that is currently active on the website. When we first install WordPress, it comes with the 2016 theme. So we want to replace this by clicking on this button here that says Add New. Then I'm going to click on Upload Theme to upload my new theme, and here we can see we can choose a file by clicking on Choose File. Here's the folder that we need, Merchandiser, so I'm going to double click on this to open it up, and then I'm going to click on Theme Files, and I'm going to click on Merchandiser.zip, then I'll click on Open. Once it has been uploaded, then I'm going to click on Install Now to install this theme. Once the theme has been successfully installed, I'm going to activate it by clicking on Activate. Okay, now when we install the Merchandiser theme, you're going to get this really user-friendly link that helps you to install the plugin that's needed for this theme. It's called Get Bowtie Tools, so I'm going to click on this link that says Begin Installing Plugin. And once I have clicked on that, there's another link here that says Install, so I'm going to click on Install. And once the plugin has been successfully installed, then I'm going to click on this link here that says Return to Required Plugins Installer. The last step here is we need to activate this new plugin we just added by clicking on Activate. Okay, so now Get Bowtie Tools, the plugin, has been successfully activated. Awesome. So next up, I want to install the child theme. So in the event we want to make some customizations to this theme, we'll have our child theme handy. So I'm going to click on Themes one more time. And we can see when I do that, instead of going to the themes page, we have this pop-up message that says, thank you for using Merchandiser with a number of steps to finish setting up this theme. We also see on the top left-hand side, there's some additional menu items here related to the Merchandiser theme. So I'm going to hold off right now on adding that child theme. We'll circle back on that in just a moment. Instead, I'm going to take care of these three steps to complete setting up the Merchandiser theme, starting with number one, entering the product key. So we can either click on this link here that says enter the product key, or up above there's another note that says Merchandiser, enter your product key to start receiving automatic updates and support. Go to product activation. So we can click on this link here. Before clicking on that link, I want to make a quick note that adding a product key is really important because it will help to enable automatic future updates, which means even though this is a premium theme, you won't have to upload or download any files when a new update is available. You'll be notified about these updates within your WordPress dashboard, and you'll be able to update without leaving the interface. Also, by adding a product key, it gives you access to the Visual Composer Page Builder plugins, which come free with the theme. With that said, I'm going to click on this link that says Product Activation. And here on the Product Activation page, we can see that we can click on this link here to generate a product key. So I'm going to click on this, which brings us to this page which says sign in with your Envato account. So I'm going to click on this link here that says sign in with Envato, keeping in mind that on another page I am signed in on Envato.com, so I'm just going to click on that. and it recognizes that I've already signed in. So it says authorize GetBowTie dashboard to connect with your account. So yeah, I want to do that. So I'm going to scroll down and click on approve, which brings us to this page. Now, what we want are the product keys. So here at the top, you may have landed on the support tab. You want to just make sure that you click on product keys. Then we'll see we can enter the URL of our WordPress website here, and we can generate a product key. So I'm going to pop in the URL of my WordPress website and click on this button that says generate product key. Okay, so here's my product key. I'm going to click on this link here to copy it. And as we see, your product key is ready to be pasted. So I'm going to go back to my website, and here I'm going to paste my product key. Then I'm going to click on this link here that says submit product key. Okay, the product has been activated. Awesome. So once the product has been activated, next up we have our plugins. When I click on this plugins tab right here, we can see that there's two plugins that we can add to our merchandiser theme, the Visual Composer as well as WooCommerce. The Visual Composer is required, so that one we definitely need to add, and WooCommerce is optional. We'll be adding both. So here I'm just going to click on this link here that says install to install the Visual Composer. And once the plugin has been activated successfully, I'm going to click on this link here to return to the required plugins installer. Okay, welcome to Visual Composer 4.12. Excellent. So next up, I'm going to click on Merchandiser one more time. Hovering over Merchandiser here, I'm going to go to the plugins page because there's one more plugin that I want to add. It's WooCommerce right here. So I'm going to click on this button here to install WooCommerce. And once the plugin has been successfully installed and activated, then I'm going to click on this link here to return to plugins. Before we can return to the plugins though, we get this pop-up box for the WooCommerce wizard, which says, welcome to the world of WooCommerce. This quick setup wizard will help you configure the basic settings. It shouldn't take more than 5 minutes. Awesome, let's go. So I'm going to click on this button that says let's go. And here we can see that your store needs a few essential pages. So I'm going to click on this link here that says continue so that the wizard can create the new pages. As it notes at the bottom, once created, these pages can be managed from your WordPress dashboard on the pages screen. You can control which pages are shown on your website via appearance menus. I'll circle back to those different items later. For now, I'm just going to click on continue. Next up, we have our store locale set up. Where is your store based? So I'm in California, so I'm going to click on this. And I'm going to scroll down to California. So you want to set your location here. What kind of currency will your store use? You want to set your currency right here. I'll leave it as the US dollar. And I'll leave it as pounds and inches. So you can adjust your product dimensions, product weights, currencies, and location on this page. Then I'm going to click on continue. Next up, we have our shipping and tax setup settings, so you can adjust those right here. Then I'm going to click on continue. Last but not least, we have our payments. So WooCommerce can accept both online as well as offline payments, and additional payment methods can be installed later and managed from your WooCommerce checkout settings screen. I'm going to use PayPal, so I'll click on PayPal right there. Then I'm going to scroll down and click on this link here to continue. Okay, your store is ready. If you'd like to create your first product, you can do so right here. And if you'd like to allow WooCommerce to collect non-sensitive data from your website, you can click on allow. I'm going to skip that, so instead I'll just say no thanks. And voila, your store is ready. Excellent. So again, if you'd like to create your first product, you can click on this large button right here. Instead, I'm going to return to the WordPress dashboard by clicking on this smaller link down below. Back on the dashboard, here we can see we have a pop-up message from WooCommerce letting us know that we haven't completed setting up our shipping methods and our shipping zones. I'm going to circle back to this a little bit later in this video. For now, I want to continue setting up the merchandiser theme. So on the left-hand side, once again, I'm going to click on merchandiser. And here we can see we've already activated our product by adding our product key. And we've also set up all the plugins or installed and activated the plugins that come with the merchandiser theme. So step three to finish this process is we need to import the demo data. So I'm going to click on demo. And here within the demo tab, as it notes, please check the system status link before importing the demo content to make sure the importing process won't fail. So I'm going to click on this link right here, system status. And we see that everything looks good. When I scroll down, there's two things with my own website that may be an issue. Number one, the PHP time limit looks like it's a little bit low. So I can click on this link to increase the PHP time limit. And it also looks that my maximum upload size is also on the short side. So if you're seeing these two messages, you can click on these links here to fix those issues. So for example, for the PHP time limit, when I click on this link to fix that issue, we can see that there's two main ways that we can change the PHP time limit. Number one, you can call your hosting company and ask them to increase it. As it notes here, the easiest way is to reach out to your hosting company and ask them to increase the max execution time to 300. Likewise, for the max upload size, when I click on this link, you'll see there's both a beginner method as well as an advanced method to increase the max upload size. Again, the easiest way to do this is to simply call your hosting company and ask them to increase it. So once the different items here have a green light, then next up, you want to click on this link here to import the demo content. You'll arrive back on this page where here, when you hover over the merchandiser thumbnail right here, you can see there's an install button as well as a live preview button. To import demo data, click on install. Okay, as it notes here, the demo content has been imported successfully. We can view our site by clicking on this link that says View Site. So here we are on our homepage, and as we can see now, the website looks a lot different than it did just a few moments ago, thanks to the demo content that we just added. The advantage of adding demo content is that it will lay out all the various sections easier for us, saving us tons of time. So we can see here that it looks pretty good. However, we need to add a lot of different images so that when we're done, instead, it will look something like this. We can see all of these beautiful images have been added, and it completely transforms what the homepage looks like. So let's add those images now. So going back to my site here, a really easy way to add these images is simply to click on the Edit with Visual Composer link at the top. So here within the Visual Composer, we can see that all the various sections of the homepage have already been laid out for us, which makes this so easy to edit. So coming up to the top, here we have the three sliders or three images that are included within the slider. So to adjust the image as well as the title tagline, the sub tagline, as well as the call to action button, all we need to do is hover over the section right here, and you'll note that this green box pops up with a pencil that says Edit Image Slide. So I'm going to click on the pencil, which brings up the image slide settings, and we can just simply adjust this. Now I'm going to leave the title as well as the title font size as they are because I really like the way that looks. But of course, you would need to just change the title, adjust the font size if you'd like, and if you'd like to adjust the title line height, you can do that as well. Also note, you can change the title font family, add a description, change the font size description. There's all these settings here that you can adjust. The only one that I want to adjust right now is the background image. So I'm going to click on this plus sign where it says background image. And here we see all of the images that come with the demo content. Now note that none of the images that I actually want to use are located here. So next up, we need to import and upload our image files. So I'm going to click on this link, upload files. Then moving over to my desktop, here we can see I have my folder with my images. I'm going to open that up. And here I have all the images that I'd like to use on my website. So I'm going to highlight all of these and I'm going to drag them to this box here. And when it becomes a blue color, we can see that I can drop the files to upload them. So I'm going to do that, and one by one, WordPress will import each of those images. Once all the images have been imported to our WordPress website, now I just need to select the image that I want to display within the slider section. So for the first slider, I want to add this particular image. So I'm just going to highlight that. And here it is right here. We can see that the dimensions are 1920 by 1000. So that is something to think about. You want to make sure that your image is wide enough that it will appear clear. If you have an image that is too small and not wide enough, most likely it's going to be blurry. So I suggest going with these dimensions, 1920 by 1000. Also note, whenever you are adding images to your WordPress website, it's important to give your images a title
and an alternative text. This is important because in the event that whoever is visiting your website cannot see images, at least they'll be able to read what it's about. This is also important for anyone who's using text-to-speech software, and it's also helpful for your SEO, their search engine optimization, so that search engines like Google can understand what your images are about. With that said, I'm going to give this image a quick title and an alternative text. Once you've given your image a title and an alternative text, go ahead and click on this button here to set the image. Okay, now we have our image set within image slide settings. Next, we need to save our settings by clicking on Save Settings. Once the settings have been saved, there should be an X right here in the top right-hand side. We can't really see it because I have a smaller window, but when I open my window right here, now we can see that there is this X and I can X out of this particular settings panel. So I'm going to click on the X and I'm going to go through this process two more times to adjust the second and the third image slider. So once again, I'm going to click on the pencil, then I'm going to scroll to the bottom. As we see here, there's lots of other things that you can add or adjust, like the title, the font size, etc. So go ahead and make your slider settings, then scroll to the bottom and click on this plus box to add a new background image. This time I'll choose this beautiful plant. Make sure that you add a title as well as an alternative text. And when you're ready, go ahead and click on Set Image to set the image. Last step, we need to save the image by clicking on Save Changes. Okay, so once the image has been added, then once again, we need to slide to the right-hand side to close this box panel right here. So I'm gonna click on this box. And then last up, we have the third image slider right here, which when I click on this pencil, we've done this before, adjust all the slider settings, scroll to the bottom, click this plus for the background image, and choose your third image, making sure that you give your image a title as well as an alternative text. Once you've adjusted the image settings, go ahead and click on Set Image to set the image. And last up, click on Save Changes to save your changes. Back on our Visual Composer, we can see that there's a number of other areas within the homepage that we need to adjust. So next up, I have these two sections, which when we hop over to the finished site, we can see when I scroll down, those sections refer to these large images right here. So I'm gonna adjust the settings as well as the images within these sections. So again, as we saw previously with the slider, I'm gonna hover over this section and click on the pencil. Here you can adjust all of your banner settings, the title, the font size, line height, the font family, and the colors, and all this other stuff as well. I'm gonna leave everything as it is. I do wanna note, however, if you do add a button, then you'll just add the URL for the button right here, whatever that URL might be, like so. I'm gonna leave it without a button, however, and I'm just gonna scroll to the bottom here, and where it says background image, I'm gonna remove the existing image by clicking on the X and add the new image by clicking on the plus. Then I'm gonna choose my image, making sure that I have a title as well as an alternative text, and I'm gonna click on Set Image to set the image. Next up, I'm gonna save my changes by clicking on Save Changes, and voila, here is our image. So again, we can't see the X to get out of these banner settings as it stands right here because my window is too small. So I'm gonna increase the size of my window and then we'll see there's an X here that I can close out the banner settings. So I go ahead and do that. And last up, I'm gonna add the desk chair settings right here by clicking on the pencil, making all my banner setting adjustments. I wanna remove the image and add a new image. And I'll choose this image and click on Set Image. Okay, then I'm gonna click on Save Changes to save my changes. Back on the Visual Composer, there's one more very important step we need to take to make sure that all the work we've done so far on the homepage is saved. And that is to click on this Update button right here. If you don't click on the Update button, then you may lose all the work you've done so far. So I like to get in the habit of pretty much every change I make, I come up to the top and I click on Update. This will update the Visual Composer and your home page. Okay, successfully updated. Awesome. So once your changes have been successfully updated within the Visual Composer on the home page, let's continue moving forward with the other parts of the home page. When I scroll down below, here we can see we have this title that we can change. So I'm going to click on this pencil, Hovering over the title and clicking on the pencil will bring up the title settings. This is where you can adjust the title, the tag, as well as the font and font size for this title. I'm going to leave everything as it is. Once you've made your settings changes, go ahead and click on Save Changes to save your changes. You can also close the panel. In addition to clicking the X in the top right-hand corner, you can close the panel by clicking on this button here that says Close. Okay, moving on to the actual items, when I pop on over to the finished site, here we can see a number of e-commerce products are displayed along with a section title. So let's go ahead and adjust those settings now. Hopping back to my visual composer, we can see here is the title. When I hover on top of this and click on the pencil, it brings up the title settings box, and we can change the title, the tags, font family, font size, and all of these other title settings. I'm going to leave everything as it is, but when you've made your changes, go ahead and click on Save Changes, and then click on this box here to close the title settings panel. Then, scrolling down, we have our e-commerce products. So in order to adjust these, I'm going to click on this box, but I do want to make a special note. When we imported the demo content, all of these settings were already adjusted. So we can see as I hover over these images, we have this settings box here with the pencil, and we can edit the products that are displayed on the home page. So to show you that, I'm going to click on the pencil, and here we can see we have the products custom list settings, and here we can see all the product categories which are currently being displayed on this home page. So if you'd like to make adjustments to the type of products or to say which products are displayed on the home page, you can simply add your product here within this product section. You can also adjust the layout style if you'd like. If you'd like to have a masonry style, I prefer the list style, so I'm going to keep it like that. If you'd like to list more than two columns, you can adjust that here, and you can adjust whether or not to show the product details. I really like the way that this merchandiser theme comes pre-installed with the demo content. I think it's a really lovely design, so I'm gonna leave everything as it is. But again, it is important to make sure that your own products are displayed, and this is how you would adjust them right here. Okay, once you've adjusted your settings, click on Save Changes and click Close. Now to actually change the images here, because we see these are placeholder images, I'm gonna click on this green box, which will open up the actual product page for this product. Here on the product page, we can see on the left-hand side, we have a placeholder for an image, and on the right-hand side, we have the title, the price, and a short description. Underneath, we have a longer description followed by some related products. So the cool thing when we import the demo content, once again, we save so much time because everything is ready to go. All we need to do now is edit our product. We can edit our product in two different ways here. As we see at the top, we can either edit the product via the classic editor that comes with WooCommerce, or we can use the Merchandiser Themes Visual Composer. Let's start with the Visual Composer. I'm going to click on Edit with Visual Composer. Here within the visual editor, we see we have a new toolbar at the top, which includes this gear icon, which when I click on it, here we can change the page settings, including the page title. So feel free to change the page title here, then click on Save Changes, then click on Close. I'm going to leave everything as it is. I just want to point out a few ways that you can make edits and customizations using the Visual Composer. So that's one way with the gear icon. When we scroll down to the bottom, we can also see when I hover over these various text blocks, once again, we get this pencil item, and when I click on it, here we can adjust the text block settings. So this is where you would add a description for your product. Again, I'm not going to make any changes here. Personally, I prefer the backend editor when it comes to editing WooCommerce products, but I just want to show you some quick ways, visual ways, using the Visual Composer that you can edit your products. Okay, so I'm going to close this box. Then we see down below we have our related products. That looks great. So a moment ago, I mentioned that I personally prefer the backend editor, and this is predominantly when it comes to WooCommerce products. Throughout this particular theme, I prefer using the Visual Composer for other reasons, especially, for example, for the homepage. But for products, I think it's a lot easier to use the backend editor. So at the top, I'm going to click on Backend Editor, And this will open the classic edit product page that comes with WooCommerce. Here at the top, we see we're on the edit product page. When I scroll to the bottom, here's our page title as well as the permalink. And then we have this visual composer within here, or what I prefer in this particular instance, again, simply for products, I think it's easier to use the classic mode. So I'm going to click on classic mode. And now we can see that the visual editor, visual composer has disappeared. And instead we have the classic editor. So to adjust this product came with the demo content that we imported. But now I want to add, for example, my own product. So instead of this demo content, I'm going to change this. I'm going to add my own product. I'll call it Modern Chair. Once I add my new product here, then you want to make sure that you do adjust the permalink. So to do that, I'm going to click on Edit, and I'm going to delete all of this info that was there by default. I'm going to delete everything, leave it blank, and simply click on OK. This will create a new permalink using the page title up above. It's important to make sure that you do adjust this, which is why I'm taking a little bit more time to really emphasize it, because otherwise you'll be using the permalink that came with the demo content. We definitely don't want that to happen. So change your page title, change the permalink, and then here in this section, you can add your description for your product. Once you've added your product description in this box, then on the right-hand side, we see we have the product categories. So I am currently on that demo content item, so I want to uncheck all these because this is not a kitchen item. I'm going to delete all these. And instead, this is simply a chair. As we see above, I'm adding a modern chair. So I'm going to call this furniture. So I'm going to click on that. If you don't want to use any of these product categories, all you need to do is click on this link here that says add new product category. Then you want to give your category a name. And if you have a parent category for this particular item, you want to add it right here. You want to click on this. Once you've added the product category here, then to actually add it, you want to click on this button that says add new product category. So add your product category title and click on this button. Okay, I don't want to do that. I'm going to leave it as furniture. So I'll just leave it checked as furniture right there. Then we want to scroll here and we want to add the price and all the data related to this product. We can see when I click on this link, we can add four different product types: a simple product, group product, an affiliate product, or a variable product. So I'm going to keep it with a simple product. This is a chair. I'm going to change the price from the demo content to my new price, and I'm going to remove the sale item. Okay, then on the left-hand side, we can see that we have some inventory. I'm going to click on that. If you'd like to add a SKU, you can add your SKU ID number here. The cool thing with WooCommerce is that it comes with these tooltips, which when I hover on top of them, it will tell you exactly what this field is all about. So as it notes, a SKU refers to a stock keeping unit, a unique identifier for each distinct product and service that can be purchased. So if you'd like to use a SKU, go ahead and add that here. If you'd like to manage stock and enable stock management at the product level, you can click on this link. Then you can add in how many products you have available, whether you want to allow back orders, and the stock status. I'm going to leave this all unchecked. Next, on the shipping, we still need to add our shipping methods. So I'm going to come back to this. We'll circle back to that. Then we have our linked products. If you like to connect this product with cross sells, upsells, or group the products together, you can do so here. Then we don't need to deal with this. These are attributes which are related to variable products, and we have a simple product. So I'm going to leave that as it is. We'll circle back to variable products later. Finally, we have advanced settings, which when I click on that, here we can see you can leave a note to send to the customer after the purchase. Okay, so I'm good to go here. Simply, I've added a price and I've made sure that it says simple product. If you'd like to, looking on the right-hand side now, if you'd like to add some product tags, you can add them here. Then I'm going to scroll down. We can see we have this product image we need to add. So I'm going to click on this. Here within my media library, I'm going to select the image that I'd like. Then I'm going to scroll to the bottom and click on Set Product Image. Awesome. If you'd like to add additional images related to this product, you can click on the Add Product Gallery Images link. And you can add an additional image for your product. Then you want to click on Add to Gallery. Awesome. So then, last but not least, here we have our short product description. So I'm going to delete everything that came with the demo content, and I'm going to add my own short product description right here. Okay, we are good to go. Then I'm just going to scroll up to the top and click on Update to update my product. Once the product has been updated, we can view it by clicking on this link here that says View Product. So I'm going to click on that. And voila, now we have our new product updated. We have the image right here, which when I click on this, it opens into this really cool slideshow of all the various images within the product gallery. And on the right-hand side, we have my new breadcrumb with the new product category it's associated with, the product title, the price, a short product description, the Add to Cart button, and then as I scroll down, here we have the full product description and our related products. So going back to the homepage, I'm going to scroll up to the top and click on my website name right here, which brings us back to the homepage. Now scrolling down, we have a few more times we need to do this. We have this item right here that looks really good, but I want to add at least three more items in the same fashion so that we can populate this area right here on the homepage. So once again, I'm going to click on this placeholder image right here. And here we go to a variable product. So I'm going to click on the Edit Product link up above instead of Visual Composer this time. So I'm going to click on Edit Product. Metal fan, that'll be my second product. Then as we did previously for the permalink, I'm going to click on this Edit button, delete the info in this box so that it's blank, and then click on OK. This will update the permalink so that it matches your second product. Okay, once we have that set, then I'm going to scroll to the bottom and add my description for this product. Once I've added the description, on the right-hand side, I'm going to adjust the product category. So I'm going to uncheck all of these existing categories right here. And once again, if you'd like to add a new product category, you can click on this link, write the name of the new product category, and click on this button. I already have an existing category called furniture, so I'm going to click on furniture, and then I'm going to scroll down. Now here's where we can change the product data here on the left-hand side. This time, I'm going to be adding a variable product. So I want to make sure that the product type is set to variable. Then first up, we have inventory. If you'd like to give your product a SKU number, you can do so, or you can simply leave it blank. It's really up to you. If you'd like to manage stock or sell this individually, you can check these buttons. I'm going to leave everything as it is. I'll leave it all unchecked. Next, for shipping, we still need to add our shipping method. We're going to circle back to this particular section. If you'd like to add weight or dimensions of your product, you can do so in this section. If you'd like to link your products to upsells or cross-sells, you can do so here. Attributes. This is the important part for a variable product. So we need to create a custom product attribute. So I'm going to click on Add. If, for example, you have the same product that has a number of different colors, that would be an example of when you would use a variable product. So I'm going to set this particular product up to be sold with a variety of colors. So the name will be color, that's my attribute, and the values will be the values, the various colors. So I'm going to sell a blue fan, a white fan, and a yellow fan. Note that I'm separating the different attributes with this pipe symbol right here, which you can find right above the return key on your keyboard. On the left-hand side, I do want to make sure that these attributes are visible on the product page, so I make sure that's checked, and I also want to use this for variation, so I have both of these boxes checked. Then I'm going to click on Save Attributes to save the attributes. Once the attributes have been saved, we can go on to variations by clicking on variations. And here we can set the default color. So I'm going to set the default color as yellow. And here we can add some variations if we'd like. Or here we see we already have our variation attributes set up right here. We simply need to set the settings. So here where it says any color, I'm going to click on blue. Then I'm going to open this. Click on open. There we go. So I have blue right here. If you'd like to add an image with a blue color for this particular fan, you can do so. I'm just going to remove this altogether. I'm not going to add an image. I am going to click on enabled. If you'd like to give your variation a SKU, you can add that here. Here is the regular price. I'm going to leave it as $120. That looks good. If you'd like to make a sale for this item, you can add the sale price and click on the schedule so that you can set how long the sale is running for. Finally, if you'd like to add stock status, weight, dimensions, or a variation description, you can add that here. I'm not going to add any of that. I'm going to leave it as it is. Then I'm going to click on Save Changes to save my changes. We still have two more variations to go, of course, because I added three colors altogether. So scrolling up to the top here, we see we have blue set. Next up, I need to change this any color from any color, which is random, to white. Now we have our white, and we can do the same exact thing. When I click on open to toggle this, here we have a yellow color, so I'm gonna delete that. You can add your image for the white product here. You can add a regular price for your product. I'm gonna add the same price right there. Then I'm going to delete this weight. I'm gonna leave it as zero, I don't want that. And then I'm gonna click on save changes. Finally, we have one more to go. So scrolling up, here we can see that we have blue, white, and yellow, and we've set the variations here for blue and white, so I have one more. So I'm gonna click on Add Variation and click on Go, which brings us one more variation option setting here. So I'm gonna click on any color, click on yellow, open this up as we did previously. It's enabled, that looks good. Then I'm going to change the SKU here, whatever you want the SKU to be. This is not a downloadable product, so I'm gonna uncheck that. For the regular price, once again, I'll give it the same price. Then I'm gonna scroll down. Everything else looks good. And then I'm gonna click on Save Changes to save my changes. So let's take a look at our variations to make sure they're set up properly. For the blue one, opening that up, it's enabled. The price is $120. It's in stock. Everything looks good. For the white product, open that one up. It's enabled. The regular price is $120. Okay, everything looks great. So now when we come up to the top within our product data section, we have one last settings area, the advanced settings. Here you can add a purchase note to send to your customer after the purchase. I'm gonna leave that blank. Okay, so now that we have the product data set for our variable product, when I scroll over to the right-hand side, we can change the product image. So I'm gonna click on this box. And here I'm going to choose the image that I want. Then I'm going to click on Set Product Image. And if I'd like to add another product image to my gallery, I'm going to click on this link, Add Product Gallery Images. And I'm going to add this second image. Then I'll click Add to Gallery. Excellent. Finally, last but not least, we can add a short product description right here. Once you've added your short product description, scroll up to the top and click on Update to update your next product. Okay, once the product has been updated, let's check it out by clicking on View Product. And here we see our product. Excellent. When I scroll to the bottom, here we have our long description. And now we see for related products, because these are both listed as furniture, although of course a fan really isn't furniture, but for the sake of this demo, I'm gonna call it a piece of furniture so that it shows up within the related products. Wonderful. So let's go back to our homepage and check out our next steps. Going up to the top, I'm gonna click on my website name, which brings us back to our homepage. And when I scroll down, we can see we have a few more items to add here to the product section on the homepage. So we have these two, that looks great. We have two more to go. I want to show one other type or product type that I often get questions about, and that specifically is how to add an affiliate product or an external product to your e-commerce site using WooCommerce. So next up, let's add an affiliate product to our homepage. So scrolling down, here's a placeholder. I'm going to click on this, which brings us to this product that was imported when we uploaded the demo content. I want to replace this and swap it out for my own product, specifically my own affiliate product. So at the top, I'm going to click on Edit Product. Then here for the product title, I'm going to replace this and instead I'm going to call it a iron teapot. Keep in mind, this is going to be an affiliate product. Then I'm going to click on permalink and click on Edit. I'm gonna delete the current permalink, which is the demo content permalink. So I'm gonna leave it blank and click on OK. That will update the permalink so that it reflects my actual product above. Then I'm gonna scroll down and add my description. Then on the right-hand side, I wanna add my new product category. So I'm gonna uncheck these two. And because I want this to be related to the other products for the sake of this demo tutorial, I'm going to call this furniture. Of course, we know that a teapot really is not furniture though, But again, for the sake of showing how these are all related, I'm going to click on furniture right here. Then scrolling down here on the product data section, we see that we have these four different product types to choose. I'm going to choose this time an affiliate product. Here's where you can add the affiliate product URL right here. So whatever that may be, you just want to add that here. I'm just going to call this amazon.com for this product URL. Okay, then if you'd like to change the button text, you can do so. I'm going to leave it as by product. You can change the price if you'd like right here. I'm going to leave it as is. That's all you need to do for an affiliate product. Here on the right-hand side where it says product image, I'm going to click on this and I'm going to change this image to my affiliate product image right here. So I'm going to click on that, click on set product image. Then scrolling down, I want to add one more product image to the gallery. So I'm going to click on add product gallery images. And I'm going to choose this other image right here and click on add to gallery. Awesome. Then I'm going to scroll down and here you can set your product short description. Once you've set the product short description, scroll up to the top and click on update to update your product. Okay, so once the product has been updated, we can view it by clicking on view product. And voila, here we have our new product, and this is an affiliate product. Note that when I click on this buy button, it's going to go to the link that I set within product settings. In this case, for the tutorial, I set it to go to amazon.com. Then scrolling down the product page, we can see we have our description again, and here we have our related products. Wonderful. So again, going back to the home page, we have a few more things to set on the home page before we're done. Here we have our slider that looks good, our other featured products. Then we have moving into brand new in the shop, our latest products. If you'd like to add one more product here, you can do so. So to add the fourth product to the section so that we have a fourth product displaying right here, we can edit this using the Visual Composer. Going up to the top, I'm going to click on Edit with Visual Composer. Then here within the Visual Composer, I'm going to scroll down to the section of interest, which is this section right here. And we can see when I hover on top of this section, we have a product's custom list settings editor, which when I click on this pencil, this will open up the product's custom list settings. Here we can see the products that are currently featured, the teapot, the metal fan, and the modern chair. So I want to add one more product to this list. So I'm just going to click in here. And when I click in this particular section, we can see all my other products that were imported with our demo content upload are listed right here. So you can choose any of these products, or if you have created an additional product, you can do so. I'm going to choose this, the California cactus, for the moment. I will choose that. Then I'm going to click on Save Changes, and then I'm going to click on Close. Also, at the top, I'm going to click on Update to update settings within the Visual Composer. Again, this is a really important thing to do because if you don't click this update button, then this change will not be saved. Okay, so once the change was successfully updated, now we see it right here. So when I click on it, here it will bring us to this particular product. I'm going to edit this product by clicking on Edit Product at the top, which brings us to the Edit Product page for this product. So first up, I'm going to change the product title by deleting the title that came with the demo content and adding my own title. Then I'm going to change the permalink by clicking on Edit, deleting the permalink or the info that is in this box and clicking on OK to update it so that it is associated and it's the same as my page title. Then I'm going to scroll down, add a description for this product. Then on the right hand side, I'm going to set the product category. So I'm going to delete these two. I'm going to click on furniture because this is furniture. Then I'm going to scroll down and here on the left hand side, I'm going to make this a simple product. So I'm just going to change the price. Then on the right hand side, I'm going to set the product image by clicking on this placeholder image and then choosing the image within my media library. I'm going to choose this one. Then click on set product image and for product gallery, I'm going to click on add product gallery images. Then I'm going to choose my other image. I'll choose this one right here and click on add to gallery. Okay, last but not least, we scroll down and here we have the product short description. I'm going to add a short product description. Okay, so once you've added your short product description, scroll up to the top and click on update to update your product. Once a product has been updated, we can check it out by clicking on View Product. And voila, here we have our product. Awesome. When I click on this image, it opens up into a really cool slideshow, or slider, I should say. That looks great. Okay, then scrolling down, here we have our description and our related products. Wonderful. So let's take a look at the homepage. I'm going to click on my website name at the top. And here we have our slider. That looks good. Our featured section. Then we have our various products, and we have four products. Wonderful. So next up, I want to change the image here for this particular section. So to customize the background image in this section, as well as the content of this section, I'm going to be using the Visual Composer. So at the top, I'm going to click on Edit with Visual Composer. Then here within the Visual Composer, I'm going to scroll down to the section of interest, which is this one right here. Now we see when I hover over each of these sections, I have all these various editors that pop up. I can edit the column here, I can edit this column, and I can edit this column. Note, however, there's also a very small, little bit harder to see row editor where I can edit the entire row. So that's what we want. So I'm gonna click on this little button here to show the row controls. And then we can see there's a pencil right here to edit the row. So I'm gonna click on Edit Row. And here we can see the general settings for the row. Currently it's set to stretch the row and the content. And we can see everything else looks really good. The one section that I want to change though are the design options. So when I click on design options, then on the right hand side, when I scroll down, here we can see this gray background right here. So this is how I'm going to change the background image for this section. So I'm going to delete this by clicking on the X to remove it. And instead, I'm gonna click on the plus symbol here to open up my media library and select the image that I'd like to have displayed. So this is the image that I'd like. Note that this particular image that I'm going to be using for my background image is 1920 pixels wide and 1280 pixels tall. I wanna make a special note. It's really important when you're adding a background image to a section on the homepage that you make sure you're using an image that is wide enough. Because if you're using an image that is smaller, then most likely the image is going to turn out really blurry. It's not going to look so nice. So make sure you're using an image that's wide. This one, once again, is 1920 pixels wide and 1280 pixels tall. Once you have your image, go ahead and click on this button here that says Set Image. Okay, now also note that here for this particular setting, it's still set to cover. So you want to make sure that this setting is set to cover, like so. Then I'm going to click on Save Changes to save my changes. Okay, voila. Then I'm going to click on Close to close those settings. That looks so nice. Now we're not done quite yet. I'm going to be leaving all of this content, but I want to show you how you can customize it. So here we see when I hover over this particular column and I click on the Edit Title button, here I can change the title for this section right here. Also, if you'd like to change the tag, how large the tag is, you can change it from H2 to some other heading title. I'm going to leave it as H2, and you can select the font family and the font size. I like everything about this. I'm going to leave it as it is, but I want to point out these settings here for the title. When you're ready, go ahead and click on Save Changes and Close to close the title settings. Next, down below, here we have another box here. We can edit the text block. So I'm going to click on this pencil, which says Edit Text Block. Note that when you open this up, it's going to be blank or appear blank, but that's only because it's a white font on a white background. Note when I highlight over this particular section, we can see these words being displayed. Also, when we see on the right-hand side, I have a visual view and a text view. When I click on text, here we can see the behind the scenes HTML as well as the text that's being generated for this particular text block. So clicking on visual tab one more time, as I mentioned, you can't really see it. However, here's this icon right here. When I click on toolbar toggle, then you get a second line of various icons you can use to change the design and the settings for this text. And one of the settings you can change is the text color. So when I click on that, we'll see it's currently set to white. If you'd like to change it to black or some other color, you can simply click on the black. So I'm going to leave it as it was with white. So once again, I'm going to click on the text color, click on white. And when you've made your settings, you want to go ahead and click on Save Changes and then click on Close. Last but not least, here we have the button. So I'm going to click on the pencil here to edit the button. This is where you can change the title of the button as well as the colors. In addition, you can change the link for this particular button. I'm going to leave everything as it is. Once you've created your changes, both for the actual text as well as for the design, then you want to click on Save Changes and then click on Close. Finally, last but not least, to make sure that all of our work is saved within the Visual Composer, the last step we need to take is to update the Visual Composer. So here in the top right-hand side, I'm going to click on Update. This is really important because if you don't click on Update right here in the top corner, then when the page refreshes, you will lose the work that you did. So let's take a look and see what our homepage looks like. At the top of the Visual Composer, I'm going to click on my website title, which brings us to the homepage of our website using the Merchandiser theme. Then I'm going to scroll down. All the sections are looking really good. We can see we have a few more things to do though. For example, we need to add one more product here, and I also want to adjust the last section at the bottom. So once again, to add that extra product, I'm going to go back to the Visual Composer by going up to the top, clicking Edit with Visual Composer. Next here within the Visual Composer, I'm going to scroll down to the section of interest, which is this one right here. And we can see there's four different items popping up, so we need to take care of that. So I'm going to choose this one right here. We can see that when I hover over this particular section, here we have this pencil, so I'm going to click on that to edit this product list. And here we can see we have two items being displayed, four columns, and everything looks okay. I do want to add another product though to this list. So I'm going to click in this particular box, and I'm going to choose the elegant chair that I added earlier in this video. Then here I'm going to scroll down. Everything looks good. I'm going to click on Save Changes, and then I'll click on Close. Okay, that looks really great. Then I'm gonna go up to the top. I'm not going to deal with this right now. I think that's gonna disappear in just a moment. I'm gonna leave it as it is. Then I'm just gonna come up to the top, however, and click on Update to update the Visual Composer. Once the Visual Composer has successfully updated, then let's check out the homepage one more time by clicking on the website title at the top of the Visual Composer. And here we have our homepage for our site. And when I scroll down to the bottom, voila, now we can see the three different images within this section, and that looks really, really beautiful. Okay, so last up, we have this bottom section here. And to adjust the styles within this section, we're going to be using the Visual Composer. So I'm gonna go up to the top, click on Edit with Visual Composer. Then here within the Visual Composer, I'm gonna scroll down to the very bottom, the last section on our homepage. And once again, this is where you can change the content and the styles of this section. So if you'd like to change the background color from this kind of blue color, you can change it by clicking on Row, clicking on this caret, which will open up the Row Settings. Then you can click on the pencil to edit the row. Here within Row Settings, you can adjust whether or not you want to stretch the row, if you want full height, all these various settings you can check out. If you want parallax or video background, all that can be adjusted here. To change the color, you want to click on Design Options. And on the right-hand side, we can see here is the color that is being added, this background color. So if you want to change that, you can simply click on Select a Color, and you can select whatever color you would like. Or if you'd like to add an image as we did previously, you can click on this plus button and upload your image. Okay, then you want to click on Save Changes and then click on Close. Likewise, you can change the content within this section by hovering over this section, clicking on the pencil to update the title. Then you can change the title right here, and then you want to click on Save Changes and Close. Then if you want to change the description text here, you can do so by clicking on the pencil and then noting that this is all white, so you need to highlight it as we did previously, change it, and you can also change the text color if you'd like. Then you want to click on Save Changes and then click on Close. Last but not least, we have this Read Our Story link, which when I click on this pencil to edit the text block, we can see when I highlight it, then we can read it a little bit better because it's white on white. And to add the link, you simply want to click on this icon right here that says Insert Edit Link. Then you want to just add whatever link you want to link to, click on the return key, and then you want to click on Save Changes and click on Close. Last but not least, at the top, make sure that you click on Update to update all the settings that you've changed within the Visual Composer. So once settings have been saved within the Visual Composer, let's take a look at our homepage by going up to the top and clicking on the website title. Here we can see our homepage looks really nice. We can see all the sections have been added to our homepage. There's a few things though that we still need to adjust. For example, when I come up to the top, we can see that within this slider, when I click on each of these items, it doesn't really go anywhere because the links are not set. So you need to make sure that throughout all of these various sections, wherever there are calls to action, specifically within the slider where it says shop now, and then we can see there's another one, shop now, and a third one that says explore, we want to make sure that these links go to the respective page. So for example, for this one, I want that to go to the shop page. So let's edit that link now. To edit the link, I'm going to click on Edit with Visual Composer. Then within the Visual Composer, we're going to edit the links within each of these slides. So on the first one here on the far left, I'm going to hover over this image. A box pops up where I can edit the image slide by clicking on the pencil. Here we see the image slide settings, and when I scroll down, we'll find that there's a URL right here that I can add. So I'm going to add this URL right now. And once you've added the button URL, go ahead and click on Save Changes and Close. We're going to do that again for the next two items as well. So really quickly, I'm just going to click on the pencil for the second slide. And here within Image Slide Settings, once again, I'm going to add the button URL, click on Save Changes, and click on Close. Once you do that for all three slides or however many slides that you have, go up to the top and click on Update to update everything that you've adjusted within the Visual Composer. So now let's take a quick look at the site by clicking on the website title at the top, which brings us back to our homepage. And now when I click on this link, it'll go to the shop page of my online store. So here we are on the shop page and we can see there's something going wrong because I don't see any products. If you see products, then you're good to go. Stay with me. I just want to fix what's happening here on my own view to make sure that the products are displaying. So if you see no products here, this may be a way to fix it. I'm going to go up to the top, click on dashboard, then I'm going to go to my pages and I'm going to do a search for the shop page. So here on the right hand side, I'm going to do a search for shop and click on search pages. And here we can see the possible culprit that's causing the page to not show the items because I have two different shop pages and I should only have one shop page. So let's take a look at the first one. When I click on quick edit, we can see the slug here, the permalink is shop, and that is the page we just saw a moment ago, the shop page. And when I actually view it by clicking on view, here we can see there are no items. This is exactly the page we saw just a moment ago. Now, if I go back and I check out the other shop page, this one right here, if I click on quick edit, here we can see the permalink or the slug is shop-2. So this is a duplicate. And when I cancel it and instead click on view because I want to see what this looks like, here we can see another shop page with all the items intact. So this is the one we want. So note that here we have shop-2. This is the shop-2 page. So I'm going to click on the back button and I'm going to delete this shop page. So I have two shop pages. One works, the other doesn't. This is the one in my view that doesn't work. So I am going to cancel this one by clicking on trash. Then I'm going to click on trash one more time, this link right here. And I'm going to delete permanently this particular page. Okay, so now when I go back, I'm going to click on all right here to go to all pages. Then I'm going to click on shop and click on search pages. And now we see we only have one shop page right here. And when I click on view, we see this is the correct page. Now note that this is still shop-2, so we need to change that permalink so that it is simply shop. Because remember, when I go to my home page right here, the link that we're using is simply my domain name /shop. So we need to change that shop page so it reflects the right permalink. So going back to the dashboard, I'm going to click on dashboard, then click on pages, then find the shop page. Here it is right here. I'm going to click on quick edit. And here for the slug, instead of shop-2, I'm going to make it simply shop. And then I'm going to click on update to update this permalink. Awesome. So now let's check out the website by going up to the top and clicking on Visit Site. Here we are on the homepage, and now when I click on this link, Shop Now, so now we see the shop page looks so much better. We have all the items being displayed here on the shop page, including the products that we added earlier in this video, including the elegant chair, the teapot, the modern chair, and the metal fan. Of course, there's other products, placeholder products that came with our demo upload. So of course, these are products that you'll need to swap out and switch so that they reflect your own products instead. Because I've already shown you how to do this, in the essence of time, I'm not going to go over how to change every single item here on the shop page, but all you need to do is refer earlier in the video where I showed you how to add simple products, variable products, and affiliate products to your online store within WooCommerce. So here we are on the shop page, and we can see that I've added a bunch of additional products to my online store. Next up, we have the sidebar here on the left-hand side, and in the sidebar, you can add all kinds of customizable content. In this video tutorial, I'm going to be adding some WooCommerce widgets, including the filter by price widget and the product categories widget. I'll also show you how you can add additional WooCommerce widgets to the sidebar. So hopping back to my website, I'm going to go to the dashboard, then I'm going to go down to appearance, hover over appearance, and click on widgets. Here on the widgets page, we can see all the widgets that come built in with the merchandiser theme, including the blog sidebar widget, the shop sidebar widget, and the search widget area. So the one we want now is the shop sidebar, so I'm going to open that up, and first I want to add a price filter for WooCommerce. So here it is right here, WooCommerce price filter. I'm going to drag it to the shop sidebar and drop it in. If you'd like to change the title, you can do so by editing that here and clicking on save. Next up, I want to add a product categories widget. So once again, I'm going to scroll down, look for WooCommerce product categories, drag that up underneath the price filter. Again, if you'd like to change the title, you can do so here. And then again, I'm going to click on save. Okay, so that's all I'm going to add for the shop sidebar. There's all these other widgets that you can add. There's also a bunch of additional WooCommerce widgets down below. So be sure to check those out if you'd like to add additional content to your sidebar. I'm going to hop back to my shop page by clicking on Visit Site. Then here on my slider, I have a Shop Now button. I'm going to click on that to go to the shop page. Voila! Now we see the content that I just added to the sidebar. That looks awesome. So here we are back on the homepage using the merchandiser theme, and we can see that everything looks really nice on the homepage. We have all the content added to the homepage as well as our e-commerce products. Very cool. Next up, I want to show you how you can edit existing blog posts that came with the demo import or create new blog posts from scratch. So to edit the existing blog posts we have, I'm going to click on blog, which brings us to the blog archive page with all of our blog posts being displayed. And here we can see there's a number of placeholder blogs that came with the demo import when we imported the demo content earlier in this video. So if you'd like to edit the existing blog post, you can do so by simply clicking on any one of these, which will bring you to the single blog post right here. And you can edit this blog post by going up to the top and clicking on Edit Post. Here on the Edit Post screen, we see all the content that's already been added to this post because this is already a published post. So if you'd like to change this post, all you need to do is override the existing content. For example, first up, we would change the title. So I'm going to change this to my own title. Then once you've changed the title, you can also change the permalink by clicking on this edit button and deleting everything in this box. Then you want to click on OK. This will update the permalink to reflect your new blog title. Okay, so once you have your blog title and the permalink updated, then you can scroll down. And here you can edit this by simply removing the existing content and adding whatever content you have that you'd like to add to your blog post. Then on the right-hand side, you can select the category that you'd like to organize your blog post in. So I'm going to unselect this and I'll choose this one instead. You can also create a new blog category by clicking on Add New Category, adding some title right here, and then clicking on Add New Category, this button. I'm going to go with the existing category right here, then scrolling down. If you have any tags that you'd like to add, you can do so by simply adding a tag in here, making sure that you separate your tags with a comma. If you have any existing tags right here, you can remove them by clicking on this X box right there. Then on the right-hand side, you want to make sure that you do click on add. So of course, these are not real tags, tag one and two, so I'm going to remove them, but I just wanted to show you in this demo how you can create unique tags. Once you've added your category and your tag, scrolling down, here we have our featured image, and we can see here this is a placeholder image that came with your demo content, which of course we need to remove and update. So to remove this, I'm going to click on this button that says Remove Featured Image, and in its place, I'm going to set a new image by clicking on Set Featured Image. Then I'm going to choose an image. I'll just choose this one right here, and then I'm going to click on Set Featured Image. Okay, so now I have my new image down below. Once you've added your featured image, you can scroll to the top and click on Update to update your blog post. Once a blog post has been updated, we can view it by clicking on this link here that says View Post. And now we see the blog post that had been imported with the demo content has now been updated. So one more way I want to show you to create a new blog post from scratch, I'm going to go back to the dashboard by going up to the top and clicking on Dashboard. Then here on the left-hand side, you'll see Posts. You can hover over Posts and click on Add New. The other way you can create a new blog post within WordPress is going up to the top toolbar, hovering over Plus New here, and clicking on Post. So WordPress shows you a number of ways to do exactly the same thing. I'm going to create a post by going to the left-hand sidebar, hovering over Posts, and clicking on Add New. As we did in the previous example, you can start by giving your new blog post a title. Then scrolling down here within this white box, you can add your blog post content. Then on the right-hand side, you can choose your category, add some tags, and click on Add. And then scrolling down once again, I'm going to set the featured image by clicking on Set Featured Image and choosing the image that I'd like to have featured. Then I'm going to click on Set Featured Image. Last but not least, I'm going to scroll up to the top and click on Publish to publish my new blog post. Okay, so once a blog post has been published, let's check it out by clicking on View Post. And here we can see our published blog post with the blog post title, the publish date, the comments, and then of course the blog content itself. Now notice that on the right hand side, there's this sidebar. The great thing about this is that you can add customizable content. So I want to show you how you can customize the content here in the sidebar on your blog post. So going back to the dashboard, I'm going to go up to the top and click on Dashboard. Then I'm going to go down to Appearance, hover over Appearance, and click on Widgets. And here we can see on the right-hand side, we have our blog sidebar. Now note that all this content comes pre-installed when you install WordPress and this theme, but if you'd like to customize this content, all you need to do is swap out this content for other content here on the left-hand side. So for example, if you want to delete the meta, I usually do that. I'm just going to open it up and click on Delete. And I'm going to delete the archives. I'll just click on delete. So here you can see you can delete whatever you like so. And then if you'd like to add other content here on the left-hand side, you can scroll down and you can add whatever content that you like. I'm going to add a search feature by pulling that and dragging it up to the top and dropping it in. And it looks like we already have a search widget there, so I guess I don't have to do that, so I'll delete it. But as you can see, all you need to do is drag the content over or simply open it up and delete it to delete this content, and then to add new content into your widget, just find the content that you like here on the left-hand side and drag it up so that it's placed right within this blog sidebar. That will customize the content within your blog sidebar. So going back to our homepage, I'm going to go up to the top and click on Visit Site. And here on our homepage, we can see that we have our menu, and this is the menu that came when we installed the demo content. So let's check out some of those pages. So here on the left-hand side, I'm going to hover over Home, and then I see I have this other submenu with all these items. Again, this came with our demo content when we imported that earlier in this video. And currently we're on the Home V1 full slider. Note there's other homepage versions that we could use if you prefer. So for example, when I click on this one, V2 featured products, here we can see this is an alternative homepage view that we can use instead of the slider that we currently have. Now note that I haven't yet added any of the images here, but these are just this is like a structure for you to follow if you prefer this view instead. And hopping over to the finished site, we see this is what that view would look like. So if you prefer your homepage to look like this, you can use that template and simply swap out the images so that it looks something like this. Now note that how we do that, all we would do is we would go up to the top and we would click on Edit with Visual Composer. So note that I'm on that alternative homepage view right here. We can see that all the images are missing because we haven't added them yet, but this is the structure that came with the demo content. And to update this so that it looks just like the completed site over here with all these images, all you need to do is click at the top where it says Edit with Visual Composer. Then here within the Visual Composer view, we can see when I hover on top of this first section, I have a row as well as a column that I can customize. So to add the background image, I would click on this arrow here under row. Then I click on the pencil to edit this entire row. Then we'll see within row settings, we can change all of these general settings as well as the design options. So here within general, when I scroll down, I'm going to leave everything as it is. But here where it says parallax and then image, here I can select an image from my media library. So I'm going to choose this by clicking on the plus symbol. Then I'm going to choose my image and click on set image. And once I have my image here being displayed, then I'm going to click on save images to save my image. Okay, then I'm gonna click on close. Okay, so once we click on close, then we'll see the image that we just added right here. Last step to make sure that this setting is saved is we need to update the Visual Composer. So here in the top right-hand corner, I'm gonna click on update. And once the settings have been successfully saved, then we can move forward. Now note that there's this white bar right here above the menu items. That's okay, that will disappear when we go to check out the website. For now, I wanna scroll down to the other sections. In the essence of time, I'm not going to go over how to edit every single section, but it's exactly the same method that we've used both to update this row as well as to update the homepage earlier in this video. So refer to those other steps to do exactly the same thing to update each of these sections. I do want to point out, if you prefer to use this kind of format for your homepage, I'll show you how to do that. Let's take a look first, though, at what this page looks like. When I click on the website name right here, we'll go back to the original home page that is currently set. Then going over to the menu item right over here, I'm going to hover over home and click on featured products. That is the second alternative home page that we just started customizing. And here we can see it right here, noting that that white bar is no longer displayed. So we are good to go. Of course, I haven't edited this whole thing because as I mentioned, in the essence of time, I'm not going to go over how to edit that. But again, simply refer to the earlier sections in this video where I showed you how to edit with the Visual Composer. I want to point out now how you can set the home page to be this alternative view if you prefer. So going back to the dashboard, I'm going to click on dashboard. Then I'm going to go down to the appearance section, hover over appearance and click on customize. One of the awesome things about the Merchandiser theme is it gives you a really easy way to customize all the different styles and appearance within your website using the Merchandiser theme in a really easy way without knowing any code whatsoever. So for example, when I click on header right here, if you'd like to change the header styles, you can do so, and you can see what the styles look like here. You can also change the background color. So like I'm gonna click on some color here, and then we can see the new color being displayed here in the header section. Pretty cool, without knowing any code. You can also change the font size if you'd like to make it larger or smaller, and you can change the header font color. Once you're done, go up to the top and click on Save and Publish to publish those changes. I'm gonna reset because I wanna stay with the default version, but I wanna point out how you can easily customize the header styles. Now going back, we can see there's this panel of all these other things that you can customize, including the header logo. So if you'd like to update your logo instead of having simply text, you can do so by coming over to logo, selecting your logo file. If you don't have that yet within your media library, then all you need to do is upload it by clicking on upload files, selecting the file, and then choosing the file. Now, the really cool thing about the Merchandiser theme is that in addition to the regular logo, you also have an alternative logo that will be displayed specifically on mobile devices. So you can upload two different versions of your logo, one for a website view and one for a mobile device view. When you're done, go ahead up to the top and click on Save and Publish to save your logo. Okay, going back, I'm going to click on the back button here. We can see there are these other header elements. I'm going to click on that. If you'd like to keep the search on, that's the search button right here. You can do so. And if you'd like to swap out the icon, you can do so by changing the file. I like this really minimalist looking search icon that comes with the merchandiser theme, so I'm not going to do that. I just want to point out some of these other options that you can change. The beauty of this merchandiser theme is that everything is completely customizable without knowing any coding, which is really awesome. Now, when it comes to header transparency, I'm going to click on that. Here we can see that we have the default color scheme is dark. So right here, this is going to be a dark background. But again, if you'd like to change this header color, you can do so by making it light or dark, changing the color scheme. All these different items you can adjust and experiment to find the different styles that work best and complement your brand. Okay, going back, I'm going to go all the way back to the beginning of the customizer and just go through some of these other features. If you'd like to customize the fonts, you can do so here, changing the size, the color, the spacing. And if you want to use Google Fonts, you can click on this. Google Fonts comes built in with the merchandiser theme. When I click on Google Web Fonts, then you can see there's all these other fonts that you can choose from. Pretty cool. Again, I'm going to stick with the default fonts by just clicking on Theme Defaults, but I wanted to point that out. Okay, so once you're all done, go ahead and click on Save and Publish to save your new settings. Now, I mentioned a few moments ago that I wanted to show you how to swap out the home page. As you can see, right now we're using the slider. When you scroll to the bottom, here it says Static Front Page, so I'm going to click on that. And here we can see currently the front page is set to that V1, Home V1, which is this slider right here. When I change that, for example, to V2, we can see that our preview window updates, and this is how you would save the new home page to be displayed as your home page. Pretty awesome. Then, of course, as we did previously, you're going to click on Save and Publish to save your new settings. I really like that slider though, so I'm going to keep it as V1, the home slider. Okay, going back to the customizer area here, you can just really experiment with all these different settings. It's so cool. There's so many different features that you can customize to make your website uniquely your own. So here we are back on the homepage of our website using the merchandiser theme. And as we can see, when I go up to the menu item, in addition to all the pages we've covered so far, we also have these internal pages called secondary pages that have come with our demo import that we uploaded earlier in this video. For example, that demo import came with pre-built about page, contact page, frequently asked questions, and an image gallery. Now, when I click on any one of these, I'm going to click on the About page, for example, we can see that the basic structure is provided, which saves us so much time when it comes to building out our own About page. All we need to do is edit with the Visual Composer to make sure that this content reflects our own business and the branding that we want for our own website. So we can see, for example, that we have this merchandiser title and we have this kind of cream background. But what we want to go for is something like this with an image in the background, and then you can change out this title to be your own website name. Then when we scroll down, we can see there's this different color with some quote right here or testimonial. We can see there's another GIF here or an image and so forth. So we can see all of these sections have unique content. So this is the end product, and all of this structure is pre-built when you upload that demo content. So of course, when we hop back over to our own About page, we see it doesn't look as exciting because, you know, we have to add the background image and change the title here, and we need to change the testimonial or the review of our business so that it is, of course, matching what our business is about and our website is about, and all these other images need to be replaced as well as the content. So in the essence of time, I'm not going to go over how to do this because, once again, I've already gone over many times how to edit with the Visual Composer. So I do want to point out all you need to do, once again, is go up to Edit with Visual Composer, and then you're going to be changing and editing the rows as well as the content to create an about page that is uniquely your own and that uniquely represents your business and your website. So in the essence of time, I'm not going to go over every internal page that came with the demo import that we uploaded earlier in this video, but there is one page that I want to go over, and that is the image gallery page. So hopping over to the image gallery page, I'm going to go up to the menu item called Home, go down to Secondary Pages, and then click on Image Gallery. Here we can see that the basic elements for our image gallery have been set up, which saves us so much time. Now where we're headed is this end result. This is the end result we're going toward. It's going to have a title on the left-hand side, a background image, and then we can see here's all the products that are going to be featured within our lightbox display of our gallery. So when I click on any one of these, it opens up into a beautiful lightbox display where we can see these products and images really easily one by one. So cool. So to get that effect, going back to our own image gallery, here we are right here, I'm going to click on this button here that says column to open that up, and then I'm going to click on the pencil. Then underneath design options, I'm going to click on that and then scroll down, and here we can see we have this gray background being displayed right here. I'm going to remove that by clicking on the X to remove it, and in its place, I'm going to click on the plus button, and I'm going to select another image that's already in my media gallery. Then I'm going to click on set image. Finally, I'm going to click on save changes and click on close. Voila! Now we have our new background. Pretty cool. The other thing I'd like to change is this title. We can see when I hover on top of the title, we have this green box that pops up with the title editor. So I'm going to click on the pencil to edit the title. And here we can see I can adjust the title, the tag, the font, and the font size. So this is where you would change your title. Once you add a different title, then you can click on Save Changes and Close. So once we've added the background image as well as customized the title on the left-hand side, next up I'm going to update the settings by clicking on Update. Once our settings have been successfully updated, then I'm going to close out the visual editor by clicking on this X button. Next up, to continue adding images to our image gallery, I'm going to go back to the classical editor within WordPress by clicking on Edit Page. Here within the classical editor, when I scroll down, here we can see we have the visual composer, and right here we see that there's already these various image ID numbers added to our gallery. So all we need to do to swap out the existing images that came with the demo content with our own images is to hover over this section, and here where it says text block, we need to click on this pencil that says edit text block. Here we can see we have our gallery kind of framework here. I'm going to click on this and I'm going to click on the text view here, and here we can see all the ID numbers of these images. Now we need to swap that out with the ID numbers of our own images once again by clicking on visual. Then I'm going to click on this right here, click on this box, and we have another pencil. I'm going to click on the pencil, and here we can add images to our gallery by clicking on select files. Of course, when we click on select files, then we'll be uploading images from our computer, and I already have images within WordPress, so instead of clicking select files, I'm going to click on add to gallery. This will bring up the media library within my WordPress website where the images have already been uploaded. Then I'm just going to select the images that I'd like to add to my gallery, and once I have all the images selected, I'm going to click on add to gallery. Okay, then you can sort these if you'd like by moving them around. And once you've reordered the images how you'd like to have them displayed, next up, click on this button here that says Update Gallery. Okay, then click on Save Changes. And then on the right-hand side, click on Update. Once a page has been updated, we can view it by clicking on this link that says View Page. Now we have a beautiful image gallery, which when we click on each of these images, it opens up into a really lovely lightbox display, and we can see each of our images one by one. Awesome. We're almost done with this video tutorial. There's just a few more things that I want to cover before we wrap up. Number one, I want to show you how you can create your own customized page using the Visual Composer without knowing any code whatsoever. This is one of the greatest features of this theme, the Merchandiser theme. It gives you a way to create your own landing page or your own website pages from scratch without any code. Let's take a look at how to do that now. So the custom page that I want to create now using the page builder is going to look a lot like this about page. We have the background image, a large title, and then we have another section with a quote. So I want to show you from scratch how you can create a page like this or any other custom page using the page builder. So to create this page, first up, we need to create a new page. So I'm going to go up to the top, hover over plus new, and click on page. Then here on our new page editor, first up, I'm going to give the new page a title, so I'll just call this demo for now. Once you have your new title, on the right-hand side, you can decide whether or not you want to display or show the page title, as well as show the footer. I'm going to remove both of these by unchecking it, then I'm going to scroll down and I'm going to save my draft. Once a draft has been saved, here we can see we have these page builder buttons or features to help us create our new page. We can either use the backend editor or the front end editor. I'm going to use the front end editor, so I'm going to click on that. And here we can see on our blank page, we can start adding content or templates. We can add elements, text blocks, or templates. So clicking on add element, here we can see all the elements that can be added to our blank page. Then we can see here we can add a text block and we can add a template. When I click on that, we can see all of these various pre-built templates that we can use. So you can experiment and see what kind of layout will work for the page you're trying to create. And these templates will help save you time in building out the page. I'm going to create mine from scratch, however, my blank page. So instead, I'm simply going to move forward and add an element. So I'm going to click on add element, scroll to the bottom and click on title because this is the element that I want to add. And then here within the title settings, I can add my title. So I'm going to use my name. I'll use a tag of H1, which is a larger font. Then I'm going to scroll down. Everything looks good. The text alignment, I'm going to center this. And then I'm going to click on save changes to save my changes and click on close. Okay, that's a little bit large. I might want to adjust that. So once again, I'm going to click on the pencil to edit the title. And instead of H1, maybe I'll just make it H2. Hopefully that'll be smaller. Then once again, I'll click on Save Changes and click on Close. It's a little better. Next up, I want to add that background image to this section. So here where it says Row, I'm going to open that and click on the pencil. And here within Row Settings, we can adjust all our settings here as well as adjust our design options. So I'm going to hop to design options, and here on the right hand side, we can see we have a background section. And when I click on this plus sign, I can add a background image. So cool. So I'm going to add this image right here and click on set image. We still need to set the settings so we can see this fully. One of the most important things to make sure that this spreads all the way across the section is to make sure you click on cover. Also, here within the padding, this is important to make sure that the title is spaced correctly. So I'll give this some top padding and some bottom padding. There we go. And I'll click on Save Changes. I'm not going to close this yet, though, because see, we still have these bars on the left-hand side, and I'm not a huge fan of that. I want it to stretch all the way across. So I'm going to click on General. And here where it says Row Stretch, I'm going to click on Stretch Row and the Content, and I'm also going to click on Full Height Row. Okay, that looks so much better. So then, once you have those two settings set, go ahead and click on Save Changes, and then click on Close. Okay, there we go. That looks so much better. Of course, you can change this title if you like to be a different color, different size. I just want to show you the basics of how to create a title as well as a background image. Okay, then of course you want to make sure that you click on Save Draft at the top to make sure that you save those settings that you just created in this row. Okay, next up I want to add another section with a quote down below, so I'm going to click on the plus sign once again within the Visual Composer. Then I'm going to choose my element, I'll choose a title, and here you can add your quote. So I'm just going to put this as a quote as a demo. Then I'll just leave everything as it is. I'm going to scroll down. I'll change the color to white, so it'll be a white quote. And then I'm going to scroll down. Let's see, what else do we have here? Text alignment, I'll center that. Actually, for the moment, I'm going to leave the color as black so you can see what it will look like. Then I'm going to click on Save Changes and click on Close. Okay, so there is my quote. Awesome. Now to create a section with a colored background, I'm going to open up the row settings by clicking on this little arrow right there. Then I'll click on the pencil to edit the row settings. And here we can see we have the similar options that we had right up above. So for design options, I'm going to click on that and I'm going to choose a color. I'll choose a color of, let's see, orange, I guess. That looks good. And I'm going to click on theme defaults and cover once again. Then I'll click on save changes. And we can see that looks pretty good, but we have this, you know, white section on the left-hand side. And I want this orange section to go all the way to the left-hand side with no white in this galley area here. So to do that, I'm going to click on general. And for row stretch, I'm going to click on stretch row and content. Then I'll click on save. That looks so much better. Okay, you can also click on design options. And if you'd like to add any padding, you can do so. That will essentially, you know, give some padding above the quote and below the quote. So let's see what that looks like when I click on, say, 20 there, and I'll add 20 there and click on save changes. Okay, it gives it a little bit more depth. You can just keep kind of experimenting to see what works best for how you want your page to look. Okay, that looks a lot better. Then I'll click on close. So there you see really easily. Oh, one last step, of course, we can't forget is we need to click on save draft. So I'll click on save draft. And then let's take a look at what it looks like. So I'm going to go back to the backend editor by clicking on backend editor. And now we can view this page by clicking on the permalink right here. So I'm going to click on that to view what my draft is looking like so far. And voila, here we have our menu at the top, a background image, a title, and we have this other section right here with a text block with a title right here. So as you can see, you can really easily customize and create any kind of page you would like using the page builder that comes built in with the merchandiser theme. Okay, so we have essentially created all the pages that I wanted to show you within this video tutorial, but there's one last step. We see that when we imported the demo content, it came with all of these extra pages and the menu set up like this. So let's go about editing, or I should say readjusting the menu so that it only includes the pages that we'd like to have included in our website right now. So going back to the dashboard, I'm going to click on dashboard. Then I'm going to go down to Appearance, hover over Appearance, and click on Menus. Here we can see we have our menu structure here on the right-hand side, and here where it says Select a Menu to Edit, we see the main navigation menu is set to be the primary menu. So this is the one that we want to take a look at. Of course, there's another menu here. I'm not sure what that is, but the one that we want is this one that says Primary Menu. So here on the right-hand side, here we can see the menu structure that came with our demo import. We see it. We have our parent menu item, and then we have a number of sub menu items and sub menu items right here. I'm going to delete all of these right here. You can leave them and check them out if you'd like, but the ones that I want to delete, I'm going to delete. Actually, you know, I think I'm just going to delete this whole entire thing because there's a lot of, you know, there's a lot of items that came with the demo import. Again, feel free to check out these pages, but for the sake of the menu, I'm going to delete this all together and create a new menu. So down below, I'm going to click on delete menu. Are you sure you want to delete this? Yes, okay. And once the menu has been deleted, now we can create our new menu. So here you can either click on this link that says create a new menu, or we can use an existing menu if you have one. So either way, create a new menu or use, you know, an existing menu. I already have one right here, so I'm going to go with that. And then I'm going to set the theme location to primary menu. That's the key step here. And on the left-hand side, these are all the pages that we can add to our menu. We have our most recent pages we've been working on, as well as all of our pages right here. And if there's a page you can't find, you can search for it within the search box. I'm going to click on view all, and I'm going to cherry pick the pages that I want to feature within my menu. I want the FAQ section. I want my home page. Remember, we're using the home V1 with that's with the slider. So I want that. And let's see, I want my shop page, of course. So just go ahead and choose whatever pages that you'd like to have featured within your menu. Then click on add to menu. Once you've added your pages to your menu, you can reorder them by simply dragging them around however you'd like to have the pages be displayed. Also, here we go, if you want to create a sub-menu item, you can simply take a page and drop it underneath the parent page over to the right-hand side just a little bit, and that will create a sub-menu item. I don't want to create any sub-menu items, so I'll just leave them all on the left-hand side there. I do want to change the name of this, however. Instead of displaying Home V1, I simply want it to say Home. So I'm going to open this little caret up here with the settings, and I'm going to edit the title right there so it simply says Home. Once you have all those menu items set the way you'd like, go ahead and click on Save Menu to save your new menu. Okay, so once the menu has been updated, let's check it out by going up to the top and clicking on Visit Site. Here we can see our new menu being displayed here in the top left-hand side, and we can see that there's really only room for 4 items, so perhaps I do want to create a sub-menu item underneath the About page. So let's edit that really quickly. Going back to the menu, I'm going to hover over the website name and go directly to the Menus page by clicking on Menus. Then here for my menus, instead of having the FAQs be its own menu item, I'm going to make it a sub-menu item underneath the About page. Then, once again, I'll click on Save Menu to save my menu. Now going back to the home page by going up to the top and clicking on Visit Site. Now we see it looks so much better. We have all of our menu items being displayed in a single line here, and then we have the names of the website. When I hover over the About page, here we have the sub-menu item. Perfect. So back on the dashboard, before we move forward and take a look at the website we've created in this video, I just want to point out we have this message here from WooCommerce that says we need to add our shipping methods and our shipping zones. There's 2 buttons here, one to set up your shipping zones and another button to learn more about shipping zones, shipping classes, and how to set up your shipping for your online store. So I'm gonna click on this Learn More button, and I'm not gonna go over this in this video tutorial because WooCommerce and WooThemes have so many wonderful videos specifically related to WooCommerce and how to set up your online shop. So I'm just gonna refer you to that button, and here you can see there's a video where you can learn all about how to set up shipping zones and shipping methods and shipping classes. So back on the website we've created with the merchandiser theme, let's take a look at our website. Here we are on the home page. We have our menu items at the top, our website title, and a search box and some other icons over here. Then of course we have our slider, which rotates through all the various images we've added to our site with a call to action here to go to the shop page. Underneath the slider, we have all these beautiful images that really showcase the products within our online store, our e-commerce products, that we have a featured section right here. And then at the bottom, we have a post going to our latest blog post. Now going up to the top, when we click on Shop Now, let's take a look at some of the features within our online store. We have our archive page, we have our slider with all our custom content on the left-hand side, and as we scroll down, we can see that our products continue to load as we scroll down. Now the cool thing about this, as we hover over and click on Quick View, we can see that a sidebar pops out on the right-hand side, which gives us a really easy way to view this one particular product. If we'd like to view more about it, we can actually go to the product page by clicking on View Details. And here we have our product on the left-hand side, the title, the breadcrumb, as well as a short description and an Add to Cart button. At the bottom, we have a longer description as well as some related projects, or products, I should say. Now let's take a look at what happens when we add this to our cart. When I click on Add to Cart, we'll get a confirmation at the bottom that this particular product has been added to our cart. And here, another cool feature about this merchandiser theme is when I click on this cart icon right here, we see that this pop-up box pops up on the right-hand side where we can see what's in our cart. Pretty cool. So anyway, then we just click on View Cart down below to actually go to the cart page. And here we have a beautiful display of our cart page. Again, clicking on Proceed to Checkout to see what the checkout page looks like. And again, we have a beautiful display here for our checkout. Awesome. So if you made it this far in the video, congratulations, because you should have a beautiful WordPress website and online store using WooCommerce and the amazing merchandiser theme by Get Bowtied. Your website should look something like this. Thank you so much for watching, everyone. I hope this video was helpful to you. If it was, feel free to leave me a comment below, like this video, and share this video with your friends. I will be coming out with more videos related to WordPress and how to build an online business. So please subscribe to my YouTube channel.
Last but not least, I want to give a big shout out of thanks to the team at GetBowTied.com. GetBowTied is a sponsor of this video and the developer of beautiful premium WordPress themes, which you can find at GetBowTied.com.
Until next time, keep learning web skills, and I'll see you in the next video.